Welcome to my live stream. FaZe, if you're still here, hello. So, let's get some farming done here. Ah, 15 miles an hour. Mike Dickey, hello. Glad to have you in the stream, Mike. Bob's in the house. How you doing, Bob? Glad you could make it. Let's see, that guy's in six. Let's put this one in three. Oh, he already was in three. Hi, Sam. How are you? Glad you could make it in the stream. Good to have you here. Let's put this one in five. And this one goes in two. That's it for now, I guess. So I had to, I know there's a number of people playing Stevie's map, Pine Cove. So I decided to go ahead and stream it today. Normally I've been streaming either Ponderosa or Sudhammer. But I do know that there's a lot of people playing Pine Cove, so I thought I'd do that one. Just for a change, a little switch up. Let me get this guy going. There's Andy. Hello, Andy. Glad you could make it. Bob, I forget a lot of things. I was going to email you, wasn't I? Shoot. Yeah, I got really busy this weekend. I was playing Farm Simulator instead of working. Troy, how you doing? Glad you made it. Well, I've only got two fields, and I got in trouble for buying one. Normally, this map comes with this field over yonder here. I think I got my speed boots on. When you first start, it starts off with this field. Well, I sold most of the equipment that was on the farm because I like to play with my own equipment, and I bought the second field, and somebody considered that cheating, and I got a comment telling me, why would I cheat on this map? I wasn't cheating on Stevie. I didn't think I was cheating. I just thought that, you know, if I'm going to make videos and live streams and I only have one field, it's going to be pretty boring. So I bought two fields, and then somebody called me out on it. But anyway, there you go. Anybody that's watched my videos, my live streams, they know that every single one of them has playing the Rude Man way. I don't play Stevie's way. I don't play probably the way you play. I play the way I play. It's my game. So anyway, that's the only explanation I've got for that. Keelan, how are you? Glad you could make it. So I've got to work fast today because, like I say, I've only got the two fields. Now, one thing about it, though, if you look at this guy here. I got him speeded up a little bit. He's actually motating pretty good there at 15 miles an hour. I could make it go faster, but that's kind of way out. 15's fast enough. But then again, I got these guys going 15 miles an hour too. And my reasoning, of course, is look at the size of the fields. You know, if you have a regular combine doing 9 miles an hour, it's going to take me all night to do just one field. So I went in and I modded this one. I modded this combine to go a little bit faster, and I modded it to dump the grain a little bit faster. Not anything unreasonable. I didn't go all crazy on it. I have one combine that does 24, 25 miles an hour, but that's crazy. Darn thing won't stop at the end of the field. It does, but not very quickly. Now, see, I got it. There wasn't very much grain in that, but I do have it speeded up just a little bit. Hi, Dar. Glad you could come in. Good to see you here. All right, so well, that's it for this field. I do have some combine compost going, but I need to get some fuel over there, which means I probably need to buy a fuel tank. I don't know if I have one. Well, I got a water tank. I think that came with the map. I didn't sell everything. I did sell quite a bit. Like, I don't need any of these cedars because I went in and modded my... This is pig pen, even though it's red. Don't let the red color fool you. This is pig pen. But I went in and I modded all of these here. Matter of fact, I modded this pig pen for Sudhammer, which has much, much more in crops than this. In Sudhammer, I modded this to do dinkle and triticale and carrots and onions and lettuce and everything else you see here. So with this being modded the way it is, I don't need those other cedars, so I'm probably going to sell them. I might buy another pig pen later on when I have more than a couple fields, but for now, I don't really need those. So let's go to the garage and sell these two cedars. Give me a little extra money because I do need to buy. I need to buy a tank. This one here. Standard wheels or Agra wheels? Agra wheels. I am just going to go with standard. All right, let me get that delivered to the farm so we can get that going. Let me get this guy going. Let's see, I need to drop the wheels. Hi, Mike. How are you? Oh, you've already been here. What's up, Mike? I know, Dinkle's kind of funny. Although, they also call Dinkle... spelt S-P-E-L-T. All right, let's get this guy back to the farm. He's ready. This guy's ready for Miller time. You know what I'm going to do, I think? I wonder if I can get in here without crunching the sides. Perfect. There, you can just sit right there. I did buy Enterprise. I kind of made it look like a bumblebee, though. Made it yellow and, well, the one color on the Enterprise that I'm using doesn't let you change it. It's kind of a yellowish color, kind of a, I don't know, a beige, a tan, a light yellow, however you want to, whatever you want to call it. But I made it the other color black, so it looks kind of like a bumblebee. I'm going to have to change it from Enterprise to Transformer. Hi, Lee. Good to have you in the stream. Glad you could make it. All right, so that's enough for that. Let's see. I need to get things going here. I think it's a little bit early to make seeds, so I'm not going to make any seeds right now. But let me see. I do need to find a tractor. Oh, let's get this guy back to work. It's kind of funny because when I first changed the speed on this to 15, I mean, that guy took off like a rocket. Well, now it's doing 20. What? That's weird. Oh, well, we'll let him go. He's a speed demon, all right. Let me get this noisy. You know, I was messing with mods all day today, and I was going to take this one in and turn the sound down a little bit, and I completely forgot about it. This is the noisiest tractor I think I've ever had. I like it, but it's really noisy. I have to yell when I'm playing with it. So anyway, as I explained earlier for some of you who came in a little bit late, I've been streaming Ponderosa and also Sudhammer, but I decided that I have quite a few people that are playing Stevie's Pine Cove, so I thought, well, I'll go ahead and stream it for something different. So that's what I'm doing. Let me grab some fuel here. I need to take fuel down to the composter. We filled it up. The built-in composter is kind of nice because it holds 100,000 in straw, where the placeable one only holds about 50. And as you know, if you've been watching me on Sudhammer, I've been making all my money on compost, so I haven't had to sell the grain. You like playing farming games, Mike? Well, this one's pretty fun. I tried to play a couple others, and I didn't play very long. Wow, this guy, he's got security cameras everywhere on this farm. Must not trust his hired workers. Or either that or the wife. The farm wife probably put those cameras up so she can make sure that her husband's working during the day. She probably keeps tabs on him. That's what I figure. I played Professional Farm Simulator 15 and 17 or 16 or how many versions came out. I didn't like it very well. I always came back to this one. Now we're waiting for Cattle and Crops to come out, and I'm hoping that Cattle and Crops aren't all hype. Lately it seems like a lot of games get a lot of hype, and then when they come out, they're not what they were proposed to be. I'm hoping that's not going to happen with Cattle and Crops. Now, the composter's on the other side of the BGA here. The only thing I don't like about the BGA, there's only one way in and out. So, there's no place to run if you get in trouble. And you know me, I'm always in trouble. All right, here's the composter. I keep calling it pine cone. You'll have to apologize. You'll have to bear with me. But for some reason, I'm having trouble calling it Pine Cove. I keep calling it Pine Cone. All right, let's give this thing some fuel and see if we can get it started. That tractor just does not want to stop. Whoa, noisy. All right, we have 90,000 in there. I thought I put 100 in there. Oh well, maybe not. 50 million on Farm Sim 16. Now, 16, is that a is that a game you play on your phone? Because I've never... Is that thing still... No, it's gone. All right, I don't need this tank anymore for now, so I'm just going to drop it here. Oh, it won't let me. Great. Let me pull it away and see if it'll let me. Nope. Nope, it won't let me. Let me just pull out of the way over here. Well, why won't it let me drop this tank? That's strange. Why won't it let me drop the tank? There we go. All right, let's take this noisy thing back to the barn. Man. And I think that the farm has a repair shop built on it. I think I'm going to take these wheel weights off. I don't know what the wheel weights do for sure, except for it seems like it makes the tractors kind of squirrely. I know it does the Massey that we have modded. If you put the wheel weights on there, it makes it drive kind of weird. So I think that's what I'm going to do. Take the wheel weights off. Put a front end weights on. Wait a minute. Can you put front end weights? Nope, this one already has front end weights. Yeah, I'm going to take the wheel weights off. Yeah, that was kind of weird, wasn't it, Dar? I don't know if I've had that happen before. Right, now I got to find that place. I know someplace on the farm... Or maybe that was a different map. My maps all run into each other. All right, it's not up here by the house. I love that little place down there. I'd like to go down there and go fish instead of farming. There, maybe over here. All right, here we go. So built right on the farm, we have this little thing here. If I can ever get this tractor to shut off. I swear to God, that sounds like a washing machine. Sounds like an old Maytag. All right, so we're going to customize it. I'm just going to take the wheel weights off and call it a day. Wow, did you see the tractor? Like it almost fell over or something. Takes 15 minutes for this thing to start. It takes 20 minutes for it to shut off. Now, why did it cost me $1,000 to take the wheel weights off when they got probably $1,000 worth of steel out of it and I got nothing? I should have got a credit for that. That's my opinion. I'm sticking to it. I'm just going to shut this thing right here, shut it down. I'm going to go grab Enterprise. Look at, Enterprise looking stylish. Looks like a bumblebee. Yeah, see that tan color? You can't change that tan color. It comes with the rig. But you can change everything that you see that's black. The nacelles and the front end and all of that changes. And then, of course, you got this lovely beacon on top. Isn't that cool? Gotta love that. Sounds like a 63 VW. Yeah, with, you know, VW has four cylinders. That sounds like one that's only running on two. Mike, not on Manchester, probably not. But I am going back to, let me see. Hang on, I need to find my trailer. I'll probably go back to some of the farms that I was playing that I didn't get to finish, like Graceland. and Oklahoma, some of those. Now, wait a minute. Where did my trailer go? Oh, I know where it's at. It's inside that big barn that has two open ends. Right here. Right, we're going to get some grass so I can start making some silage. One of the things I like to do when I start a new map is get prepared for animals. So I like to get silage going right away because I can get straw and grass really easy, but you need silage to make mixed rations, which takes more grass. Oh, wait a minute. Come on. There we go. All right, let's get Enterprise out there and cut a little bit of grass. Now, I was cutting the grass between the fields because I didn't know there was anywhere else to get grass, but right on the other side of the pigs right here, there's a field I didn't realize was there. And I'm gonna go over that way, and then I need to get that cedar going. So let me just kind of bring this thing over here. And there's plenty of grass between the fields, but I didn't notice this field right here. So I'm gonna get some grass right here, but I need to get that cedar going, which means, I apologize, but I'm gonna have to start this tractor up again. Sorry. Man, I really gotta go in there and turn the sound down on this mod. By the way, any of you that watched that tutorial I did on mods the other day, I've been thinking about it, and a couple people have asked me to do more. I don't particularly do a lot of tutorials because there's so many other people out there doing them. And, you know, I just didn't think that there was any reason for me to do them too. But I did that one the other day, and it was pretty well received. And I try to make them easy to understand. So I'm thinking about, well, I'm not thinking about it. I've already started doing it. I'm going to make one I started recording it today. I'm going to make one on combines. I want to teach you how to go in and change the speed that the combine dumps into the trailer, the speed the combine can travel, and the either without a header or with the header, how to change the bin to have a larger size, all of those kind of things. I want to do a tutorial that kind of helps teach you how to do that. And then I'm going to go to cedars and do a tutorial on to try to teach you how to put more fruit in it. So that if you're on a map that has, say, rye and oats and things like that, I want to do a tutorial help show you how to do that. Renner's in the house, and Blake's in the house. Hello, Renner. How you doing, Blake? Blake's one of my favorites because I used to be a cowboy when I was young, and Blake Garrett just sounds like a cowboy name to me. And you know what I just did? I just left without putting seed in this thing. It's not going to do me any good at all. Well, anyway, long story short, keep watching because I'm going to do a few more tutorials. And as long as people keep liking them, I'll keep making them. I'm going to get in trouble, though. I just know it. It's kind of like, have you watched that show where the guy is a magician and he's out there and he's showing you how magicians do their act and stuff, and all the other magicians put a death threat on him, that kind of thing? That's what I'm afraid of. I'm doing tutorials to show you how to easily do a mod, and the modders are going to come after me. I know, Blake. Yeah, it's the little things in life, isn't it? Hi, Ryan. How are you? Glad you could make it. I gotta get that water tank out of the way, too. Look at the chickens. Run over chickens. I wonder why in Farm Sim 2017 they didn't let you buy chickens. You don't buy chickens anymore. There is a mod out there that lets you buy chickens now, I guess, but you just get a bunch of chickens and they just run all over the house. Now, who in their right mind would have their chickens right up against their house running around? You heard what kind of noise they make. I'd be strangling chickens every day. Doing good, Ryan. Any of you guys have Costcos where you live? And if you do, have you ever had a Costco hot dog? I had a Costco hot dog for lunch today. And there's a peculiar thing about Costco hot dogs. Now, you get the choice between beef and Polish. And I always get the Polish because I like things that are a little bit more tasty. And you eat a Costco hot dog, you can burp the alphabet for about 3 days afterwards. Has anybody else found that out? Ah, Blake, you got it made, buddy. Okay, so if you've noticed, I modded this thing to go a little bit faster. Again, I try not to make it go too fast because that's not quite right. I kind of figured 15 miles an hour is not too bad. I did have it going 24, but that was really too fast. So I kicked it back down to 15, and I modded it so that it holds everything that I could put in it. This thing has not only all the regular ones, it's got oats and rye and dinkel and triticale and onions and lettuce and everything that you can do on Sudhammer, this thing's now able to do. I did that last night. But I got to get over and get some grass going here. Yeah, Costco. Okay, uh-oh. Did I turn my mic off? No, you can hear me. Yeah, Costco hot dogs are great. I kind of love to burp the alphabet. I don't know where to start here. I'm just checking the field out to see what we got here. Well, it's actually pretty square, isn't it? So it doesn't really matter where I start. I'll just start right here. Why not? All right, so let's start this guy up. Let's start this guy up and drop him down and let's grab some grass. You know what I might do just for hoots and giggles? I better not. I'll just mow. I tell you what, you've got this little field here which will give you a pretty good amount of grass, but there's quite a bit of grass in between all the fields too. Hi, Brian. Good to have you in the chat, buddy. Thanks for coming by. I appreciate it. Somebody asked me the other day about this forage wagon. This particular forage wagon does pick up twice the amount of grass. So whatever I would get on with the regular forage wagon on this field, I'm getting twice that amount. Now, Haas modded this to do that because we were working on Ponderosa, which didn't have a lot of grass. These fields were kind of small, and we needed a lot of grass to get started, so we did that, and we just left it that way, and I'm still using it that way. to me, grass is, even though it's so important on the farm, it's kind of a side product, really. You know, it's not like your grains and your earth fruits and things like that, your proteins. It's not necessarily like that. It's kind of a byproduct. For some reason, you have to cut grass for the sheep to eat when they've got a great big pasture that they're eating in all the time. So I don't know what the difference between this grass and that grass, unless it's the grass is always greener on the other side of the fence. It's the only thing I can figure. And then the only other thing that you do is you can make silage out of it, but you can make silage out of chaff. So I kind of consider grass a byproduct, and so I don't want to spend a lot of time cutting and mowing grass all the time. So I don't mind using this mod that gives me twice the grass for that reason. Thank you, Mike. I appreciate that. Carlos is in the house. How you doing, Carlos? Yeah, a lot of people get after me, you know, like I'm cheating because I use stuff like this. But the thing of it is, if I'm playing on my own, that's one thing. Because I've got all day. I can sit and play for 2-3 hours. But if I'm making a video, you guys really want to sit there and watch me mow a field of grass all day? So I don't mind using something that gives me a little edge. Let me go find the combine and find out. Not the combine. Oh, he's done. Okay, let's get him buttoned up then. Oh, you finally ordered it, Renner. Are you getting a disc then? Oh, shoot. Missed a couple places here. Limit to fields. All right, heck with it. I'm going to leave that. Thank you, Carlos. Appreciate it. Yeah, I know, Brian. Doesn't make any sense, does it? Like I said, I think it's the grass is always greener on the other side, and you're doing it just to keep them happy. That's what I think. Yeah, Blake. Oh, by the way, Andy's in the house, I think. Andy asked me last night what Mountain Dew was. I had a hard time explaining it because it's not quite a citrus drink. On the other hand, it kind of is. I think it's a little less acidy than, I can't explain it, what Mountain Dew is. But it's not quite like a squirt or a 7-Up. It's more like Sprite, in a way. It's just better. Of course, that's my opinion. Is chaff more lucrative? It all depends, Bob. It depends on what the price of corn is at the time. And it depends on whether you're using the chaff to make silage, and then if you are, what's the price of silage? It's hard to say, really. I kind of look at it a little bit different, though. I try not to look at the financial gain or loss of it. I kind of try to look at it in the respect that if I'm tired of growing grass and I've got corn and it gives me the chance to use a different piece of equipment and do something a different way just to break the monotony of the game. That's the way I look at it, because I know a lot of people have said, hey, Rudy, you know, you could have got more money if you'd done that. Or I buy a field that has beets on it and I get a machine to do the beets, and they say, you know, you spent 3 times the amount on that piece of equipment than you got for those beets. I realize that, and I know that, and I know it doesn't make any sense, but to me, it's the fun of playing the game, because I don't do beets very often, and it's kind of fun to do beets once in a while, because it's a different piece of equipment, and it's something different to do. So I don't look at it as, you know, a dollar and cents kind of a thing. So, Renner, are you saying that chaff is more lucrative than corn? Renner's a real farmer. He'd be able to tell us in real life. No, Andy, I didn't. It was here on the farm already. Andy's asking about this washer. I did not place it here. All right, let me go check out the cedar and see how he's doing. Where is the cedar anyway? He's done. Okay, I did wheat on that. What else should I probably shouldn't have done wheat. What else do I need? I need something for the pigs. So let me go with soybeans. Oh, I'm gonna need potatoes. I'm gonna do soybeans this time though. There is a field of potatoes close by. Let me see. Potatoes right there. Oh, maybe not. I thought there was. I thought one of those fields had potatoes on it. On the map I put on the server, it did. I think one of these did. Huh. Oh, well. I'll work it out later. I'm just going to do soybeans. Okay, all right. Sorry, Renner. I'm getting behind on the chat. So, okay, so you got 15 on a disc instead of like a steam or something. That's good. By the way, Renner, once you buy something on a disc, if you're not familiar with steam, you can always add it to steam. I don't know if you'd want to, but you can. And then Steam would auto-update it. There are pros and cons about using things on Steam. You know, one of the pros is you can get some pretty good games at very cheap prices because they have sales all the time. The other pro is that they automatically update your games when there's an update. The cons are that you have to use Steam to play the game, which is kind of a bummer. But there's kind of ways to get around that too. Hang on, it's soup du jour time. Ah, refreshing. You know what? I found that opening a can of pop doesn't sound the same as opening a can of beer. Now, I didn't know that because I don't drink beer, but I was around somebody the other day that did, and when they opened their can up, it had quite the snap to it, more than the pop has. I didn't realize that. So what I'm going to have to do is I'm going to have to start popping beer in here and then drinking the pop and giving the beer away to somebody that drinks beer. All right, let me get this grass put away here. Tell you what I'm going to do though. I shouldn't put that away. What I should do is go ahead and mow that. I like Orange Crush, and I haven't had it for a long time. You know what I like every once in a while? I don't drink it very often because I don't want to get sick of it. I like cream soda. Has anybody had cream soda lately? I found some the other day made by A&W, and I think it's really good. Hey Wayne, how you doing? I'm doing well. Just doing a little farming. Uh-oh, I'm gonna hit that tree. Oh man. Why? Well, I guess you can't have a map called Pine Cove if you don't have pines on it, right? Kind of like the Ponderosa, you expect it to have trees on it. All right, let's see. Do you know how to run the game through Steam without it popping on the main PC? You mean Steam popping on the main PC, Bob? Oh. I've never had that happen, Blake. FaZe, are you the same FaZe that comes in all the time? Yes, good stuff. Brian, that's good stuff. Your wife sounds like a smart woman. The bar company. I killed me a bar. That's what Daniel Crockett, no, Davy Crockett, Daniel Boone. I get those two mixed up all the time. Killed him a bar before he was whatever. Can't remember the song. It used to be a song about Davy Crockett, no, Daniel Boone. I get them mixed up. Davy Crockett was King of the Wild Frontier. Daniel Boone was, I don't know what Daniel Boone was. All right. You'll be heading home soon, Wayne. Maybe. Well, FaZe, if you're the same FaZe that we all know and love, then I already said hi to you because you came in earlier before I even started the stream. And the first thing I said when I came in is, FaZe, if you're still here, howdy. And you didn't respond, so you must have left. So I did give you a shout out already. Oh yeah, Bob, it does that. It does that because it allows you to stream. So I can stream from one computer to another. I got about four computers all hooked up here, and what you need to do is just go into Steam on the computer that you don't want it to run on, and just put it in the offline mode. Only problem is every time you start it, it wants to start. So if you'd have to go into your start on your Windows and tell it not to start when you start your computer up. All right, unfortunately, that silo only holds 100,000 units of grass. $4 a can, oh my goodness. It must be made out of real beer. Or the roots are kind of hard to find. I don't know. It's root beer. I know. Transport fever? I don't think so, Mike. I'm not familiar with what it is. All right, that's enough grass for now. I might go out and get some more if I don't have anything else to do. But I want to go check and see what all the compost is doing. So let me grab this booger and drop the trailer. This is the truck and trailer that I did the tutorial on the other day. So I pretty much left it with what I did. So they both hold 50,000 now. Whoa! I always go too fast. Yeah, that's kind of a problem, Bob, the Steam there. When I'm on my computer doing things, and if my wife has a laptop, and when she signs on her laptop, all of a sudden I get a notice on my desktop PC that the laptop is available to stream to. And, oh man, I forgot. Do I have any money? I got a little bit of money. Let me see. Did I put... Oh, I bet I didn't put them in. Uh-oh. Did I put my mods in? Oh, no. Which one's that one? Oh, no. That's not it. Is it? What's that one? Okay, that's cow. There, Compost Man. I need that one. 60,000. I barely have enough money to buy it. Let me buy that. And we'll run to the store and pick it up. These things are kind of hard to drive because they go, whoa, they go crazy. These things will turn on a dime. Look at that. You gotta be careful of these things. Now, I got this one modded to pick up compost. So we'll go pick up the compost with it. Then I gotta figure out where to sell the compost. I'll tell you what I'm going to do. Let me see if I've got it in here, placeables. All right. I've got a mod that I got in here. Did I put it in? Yeah, nope. There's the manure one. Oh, no. Lizard. Sell point. I have the sell point. Hey, FaZe. Thank you. Appreciate it. All right. I do have the sell point. I got to figure out a place to put this. Where should I put this? You know what? I might want to put it close to the farm. Now, that sell point right there, it's a mod. It's not mine. I found it on Mod Hub, I think. I do, Mike. I play the crew. What's that Xbox one? I can't think of the name of it. I play Dirt Rally. I play a couple of different racing games. Anyway, that sell point is not mine. It was on Mod Hub, and I downloaded it. But it lets you sell almost everything you can think of, which is good. It just gives you another sell point someplace that might be maybe a little handier. This thing looks like what it drives like a whale too. A beluga whale. Okay, so I think I might put that sell point in this empty lot right here. And I might put the manure storage there. Hey Renner, thank you. So now, the manure storage, I don't know if there's a place, again, forgive me if there is. I've not really played this map very much outside of just driving around it that way. Well, I didn't even drive around it. I ran around it that day and did a video of it. And I'm sure there's a lot of stuff I missed that's on this map. So I don't know if there's a place to store manure. But I have one in a placeable mod, right? There. It's only $3,000. I think I'm going to put it in. So it's not that big. And let's see. Let me put that. Let me spin it around. I'll put it on this side over here. And I'll put the sell point on the other side. Well, I'll tell you what. I think I'm going to put the sell point in first. Because I don't know how big it is. Well, it's not very big. Cool. All right, let me spin this around. Tom Clancy's Wetlands. Hey, Jack. Didn't see you come in. Thanks for being here. I haven't looked at that one yet. I got Resident Evil 7 today. I can't wait to start playing it. I watched a review on that one. It says pretty good. All the rest of them are pretty good, although they scare the snot out of me. I scare easy. It's not my fault. I wait till I'm tired and it's late at night and it's quiet and it's dark. I turn all the lights off and I start playing those games and I scream like a little girl every time something scares me. Not my fault. All right, so we got that. Let's put in the manure place. We don't have manure yet, but we will. So I'm going to get in preparation of that. This thing's only $3,000. so I'm not wasting too much money. So I'll put this in over here. Let me see. Need to make sure I put it in a place where I can get under that without too much trouble. That conveyor belt there. And let's put it closer to the edge, I guess. Right about here. All right. So there we go. So now we don't have manure, but we will. I'll start buying animals sometime. What's my name on Steam? My name's the same everywhere, Rudeman. It's either Rudeman or Rudeman 53. And believe it or not, there's 52 people ruder than me. Can you imagine that? Hey Craig, how you doing? I didn't see you come in. Glad you're here. Goodbye money's right, Blake. I gotta make some money. That's why I got the compost maker. I'm glad I bought it first, so I had enough money. Let me run up here and grab some of this. I need to make money, money, money. Oh, no. Okay, Blake. What was the issue? Did you get claustrophobic? Because I've had those things, and I fall asleep in them. And if anybody's had an MRI, I don't know how I do it, but I fall asleep in everything. I fall asleep in a dentist chair. I fall asleep when I get my hair cut. Hey, Case, how you doing? Anyway, an MRI, if you haven't had one, you put you on this little conveyor belt thing, and they take you inside this thing that looks like a hot dog bun, and you can't move. It's like they put you in a tank. And then it sounds like 15 Thors with hammers are hammering on the side of that thing for 20, 30 minutes. Well, I fall asleep in those things. And I had to do it twice. I sat in there for 25 minutes and they were doing my neck because I had injured my neck. And I got out and they said, oh, you got to do it again. And I said, why? And they said, well, you must have fallen asleep and your mouth fell open. And that's the area that we were looking at. And so it wasn't clear, so you got to do it again. And I said, well, you told me to relax when I went in there. Well, you can't get much more relaxed than falling asleep. At least that's my opinion. No, I'm not narcoleptic. I just don't like to do those things. So whenever I have an issue, like if I have a headache, I don't like taking medicine. So if I had a headache, I just go to bed and go to sleep. And when I wake up, the headache's gone. Well, it's the same thing. If I go to any place where I have to wait, I hate waiting. Like for a haircut, or you're sitting in a chair waiting for them to finish, or sitting in a dentist chair waiting for something. It's just easy for me just to fall asleep so I can get it over with. So I can wake up and go home. I'm not narcoleptic. I just have the ability to sleep anywhere I want to. Well, see, I used to drive truck. And when you drive a truck, you get tired. So you have to learn that you can pull over, lean back for maybe only 5 minutes and get 5 minutes of sleep and wake up and then hit the road again. So I kind of learned that I can sleep anywhere. Yeah, Jack. And also, there are some bigger hospitals now that have what they call open MRIs. They're not closed like that for people that have claustrophobia. There's a claustrophobia. They have open ones now. I made $121,000 on that compost in that suite, and it wasn't very much compost either. If you noticed, it didn't even fill this thing even a quarter of the way. Of course, I got this thing beefed up to hold a whole heck of a lot. I think I got this thing set to hold about 100,000 units. Oh, thank you, Dar. Thank you. I didn't even look. Oh, you could have saved me some money, dear. Oh, well, I kind of like my composter. Oh, there it is. Oh, man. Okay, well, you know what? The Silo King's not wasted, though, because I plan on putting in the placeable composter. So, because there's plenty of room here, I'm going to put the placeable one here, and I'll need that for that because it doesn't have one of those. The only difference is this one I think will hold 100,000 hay, and the placeable one only holds 50,000. But thanks anyway. I should have looked. My bad. All right, Bob. Thanks for coming by. Appreciate it. All right, let's head back to the farm, see what's going on. Well, so now we got some place to store the manure if we ever get any. We gotta buy cattle first, I guess. Wonder how long it takes to make silage. I wish that silage maker made more. Let's see, where was it anyway? Was it over here? I think it was. I think it's back here. Let's see what we got. I have a placeable mod that looks just like this, but when I use it on a server, it dang near shuts the server down when you use it, when you're doing what I'm doing right here. Oh, look, I already put straw in here. Cool. Let's get this silage put in here. Now you know why I wanted these dump trucks. They're a lot easier to get in these places like this. Now we got some grass we can put in there, too. Blake, you've got cerebral palsy. I'm sorry. Man, that's terrible. That's a terrible disease. Alright, let's put some grass in there and then we'll start making some silage. No silage. There's the straw. There's the grass. Going back and looking at the chat here in case I missed anything. Case, I'm doing good. Thank you. Appreciate you asking. Wow. That took exactly what I can hold. Good thing, huh? I don't think it'll take that much, but we'll see. I like the way this truck drives, too. Now, this truck's kind of weird because, well, it's not weird, but I thought about boosting the speed up because I thought it was slow, but it really isn't slow. It just slow starting, which is kind of good in a way. I don't like those ones where, you know, they kick them up to go, you know, 60, 70 miles an hour or something like that. And they just take off like they've got rocket power. I don't care for those all that much. This one, it does get up to speed, but it doesn't do it very quickly. Okay, so I'll show you. See, I got it floored. So look, it takes a while to get going, but then when it does, it really does go pretty quickly. It's just slow starting, and that's okay. All right, so I got that going. You know, I should have stayed around to make sure it worked okay. Where am I? Got lost. Whee! Oh, there it's moving. All right. It's making bacon. It's making bacon. Oh, my wife bought some new bacon today. We generally get the thin bacon, and she got the thick kind, and she wasn't sure whether she liked it or not. Boy, I do. I like that thick bacon. Let me check, see how my cedar's doing. Is he done? All right, there we go. I got to make some money to buy a new field. You know what, though? Somebody told me that was playing this. What? YouTube beta strikes again. Chat's dead. YouTube beta strikes again. Chat's dead. Oh. Oh, I haven't even been watching. Thank you, Blake. Oh, I hate when it does that. Because it usually doesn't come back. All right, we'll see how long that lasts. See how long that lasts. Anyway, what I was saying was somebody told me that plays the game that the fields are very expensive on Pine Cove. I haven't went and looked yet, but they said even the small ones are quite expensive. That's not good. How many mods do I have? It's hard to tell because I don't have them all in every map. I only put in the mods that I want to use on a particular map. So I've probably got a couple hundred, but I don't use them all on every map, if that makes sense. What happens is, like, I've probably got 5 or 6 different cedar mods. But I don't use all of them on any given mod. I usually find one I like, and I put that on the map. Like, I have one. I think I've got it in here. Let me look. I'll tell you what I'm talking about. Right here. Right in here. I think this one. This one right here. I like this mod. It's a well-done mod. But this thing is a monster. It's just huge. This does not work well on a farm that has very small roads or very small fields, so I don't use it on a map like that. If they get out a decent 4K map, then I'd probably start using this one. But right now I can't. I tried it on a small map and it was not usable. So I kind of like this one because it's fairly big, but it's not too big. And so that's what I mean. I've got tons and tons of mods, but I don't use them all. I use whichever one I think works best on whatever map I'm playing. And also, I choose to use the ones I really like. Like right now, I really like these combines here that I'm using. Because you can make them any color you want. They've got a pretty good size bin. I boosted them up so that they go a little bit faster than normal. But I really like them. They're well done. They're pretty good detail on them and all that kind of stuff. I just really like them. Alrighty. Let's see. Let that guy go. Let this guy go. You know what I need to do now? I really don't have anything to do until my crops come back up. So here's what I think I'm going to do. Just for sake of having something to do, I'm going to speed up time. So forgive me if you think this is cheating, but otherwise I'm just going to sit here and wait for these crops to grow, and that's no fun. So here we go. All right, now I want to stop the... Oh, there we go. Vehicle running, loan interest, property income. I don't have any cows. I can't wait to get some cows to find out whether they sell the milk at midnight. I might have to put a milk thing in here if there's not one in here. All right, so that didn't help me. It's still not ripe yet, but when you speed time up like that, oh, there you go. So you have to wait for it to catch up. In 15, when I used that mod, it was like instant, but in 17, it's not. I did, Blake, and it didn't work very well. It was actually too big. It was just too big. The fields on Suithammer around the farm are not very big fields. Let me see if I can get this thing ripened up here. So I can have something to do. Man, I don't want to lose the whole day. Come on. Whatcha going on? There it is. Takes a second. Whoa! It really did catch up. That's what I mean. You gotta be careful. It just takes a while to catch up when you do that. Uh-oh. Guess I'm gonna need my header. Or do I have it? Oh, what am I doing? Oh, I have it already. Never mind. I guess I could have looked first. I get rich and famous, I'll buy me a second combine, but I'm going to have to do with this one now. I kind of miss my beer bottle brown one. On Ponderosa, I've got a beer bottle brown one. I think I do on Suithammer, too. Milk auto sales, yeah. Do you play this this map, Brian? I know several of you are. That's why I decided to live stream it. Okay, Carlos. Thanks for stopping by. I appreciate it. Stew for dinner. I like stew. We do stew quite often because we kind of like to do... It's just a wife and I, and we kind of like to do stuff like stew and chili and stuff like that once in a while so that we don't have to cook for several days. We're always fighting over who's cooking tonight. I don't know. Don't we have any TV dinners? Yuck. TV dinners. There's a meal for you. All right. Let's see what we got here. I hope I've got the windrow set up. Let's see. What's happening? Why is it not working? Hang on. I thought I hired a worker. Trying to get that... There we go. Trying to get that wheel down there. And then have it come in. Alright, I guess that's all it's going to do. So, let me see if I can hire a worker. That's what I was trying to do. Who do we have working? Hey, Raymond. Raymond LeDuc is... Well, wait a minute. He quit already. Raymond! Hey, Kirk. How you doing? You going to give me all my cow, all your cows? Uh-oh, no windrow. Give me some windrow. I know you have windrow, your wheat. Well, I'm glad you're here, Kirk. I'm glad you're here. Pull up a chair and stay for a while. We'd appreciate it. And everybody's welcome to chat. If everybody starts chatting, that's when the stream gets fun. So don't be shy. There's nobody going to bite you here, that's for sure. But I'm glad you're here. All right, so while he's doing that, let me go set up a tractor and a trailer. Venison? You had venison or you hate venison? I like venison. Venison, good. All right, let's see. Let me mosey over here. Grab this trailer. I kind of thought that's what you meant, Mike. Where I live, or where my family lives, my family, they're all big hunters. And because we need the meat. We don't hunt for fun or trophies. We don't take trophies. We don't stuff them. We hunt deer for food. And where we hunt is almost all grain fields. It's wheat country, grain country. And the deer come down and eat the wheat and the barley and the grain and the canola, whatever they can eat. And so they're like grain-fed beef. So when we have deer meat, it's good. Thank you, Kirk. I appreciate it. Thank you very much. Yeah, there's nothing better than that. It's, like I say, it's like eating grain-fed beef. Now, there is other places in, I'm talking about Washington State, that's where my family lives. There are other places in Washington State where the deer are up in the mountains, you know, and they eat sagebrush, and they eat, you know, whatever they can find to eat, and it that meat is kind of gamey. But where we hunt, they eat the grain. That's good eating stuff, I tell you. I really got to go in and turn the noise down on this mod. This tractor mod is so noisy. I like it, but it's loud. You like the backstrap, huh? Yeah, people nowadays are a little bit different than people used to be in the Wild West, times like that. When they ate an animal, they ate every part of the animal, every single part. That was your first deer, huh, Mike? Well, good. Had you been hunting before and not gotten anything, or is that the first time you went hunting? Hey, that combine better hurry up. Oh, he's almost full. I gotta go get a truck. Where's my trailer? John Deere trailer, that John Deere tractor is still shutting down. I'll tell you, my family, the way we used to hunt is, and I'm talking my brothers, my cousins, we used to go hunting as families, you know, and what we would do is everybody would get their license, and you know, you have to get a doe permit at certain times of the year. But what we would do is we'd all get our license to hunt, and we would go hunting. And so what we did, though, it didn't matter what you shot. If I shot a deer, I didn't necessarily get that deer, because what we would do is we'd go hunting as a family, and everybody would hunt, because the important thing was that everybody got their deer. And so if I shot a deer and it was a little bit smaller than what my brother shot, what we did was when we got home and butchered, we butchered it all out, and everybody got the good meat, you know everybody got what they got. So we shared. So if somebody got a smaller deer or whatever, it didn't matter. We all got the same amount of meat. See how fast I set that to unload? All right, where's the rest of it? Gimme, gimme, gimme. What's happening? There it goes. Cool. ...12-gauge shotgun. What were you hunting? right, let me go put this straw away. I tell you what, I wonder, I'll wait. I got $233. $233. I have $233,000. That's enough for that second, compost maker. I'm debating whether to buy that or not. Because I'm going to get a lot of straw. I might have to think about it. Kirk, I try to do Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. And then every once in a while, I'll kick one in on Tuesday or Thursday or on the weekend if I have something I want to do. But I try to do at least Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. And I play a lot of other games besides this, too. I play Elite Dangerous, and I have a second page for most of that, though. Most of my subscribers come from the farming, so I pretty much farm all the time. But I do like to play other games. And, like, I just bought Resident Evil, and I'm thinking about doing Resident Evil, but it'll probably be on my other channel. I have another channel that I put role-playing games on. Like I do Fallout 4 and Skyrim and lots of different stuff. Mass Effect, Fallout 3, Dragon Age. I like RPG games a lot. You hunt deer with a shotgun, huh? As a matter of fact, talk about games. I do also play that Cabela's Big Hunt where I hunt. As a matter of fact, I think I just put a new episode up today on the other page. I put episode 9 up today. I wonder where Scorpion's at tonight. Scorpion's not on and Bill's not on. Somebody said Bill was sleeping. I don't know if Ryan's still here or not, but I think Ryan said Bill was sleeping. Bill lives in Sweden, so it's pretty late for him about this time of day. Of course, and Andy's from Scotland. I know it's late for him. Who else do we have in here that's from across the pond? Yeah, I know, Wayne. The ones that I'm putting on the other ones are ones you've probably already seen. I'm trying to catch up to where I was. What happened was, I'm not getting, because most of my subscribers come from the farming, my page isn't doing well compared to some of the other farming pages, because I do other videos where some of the other guys do nothing but farming. So you know when you go onto a page and it says, do you want to see a related page like Daggerwind? Daggerwind does farming. And you go on his page and it says, do you want to see a YouTube that's related to this page? I think because I have so many other games I play that it doesn't consider me, YouTube doesn't consider me a farming page. And so I never get on those other related page lists. So I'm starting to put my RPG games over on my second page. And I'm trying to catch up with the hunting one. As soon as I get episode 12 put up there, I'm going to start making some more hunting ones. And somebody said, I play a game called The Hunter, and somebody said that they're got a new one of those coming out. Yeah, that's a good one, Craig. Bill likes the beats. Yeah, I'll think about that, Blake. I tell you what, on the second page, I'm going to start live streaming over there, but I'll be live streaming other games besides farming. I'm going to try to keep just the farming games on this page. There's Bill. How you doing, Bill? Yeah, it's my fault.
That's okay.
Bill and Craig and I played on this map on the server most of the day Saturday. What's on my second page? I'm just kind of starting it, but I've got my role-playing games over there. I'm putting like my Fallout 4, Skyrim. I've got a game that's it's a mod actually. It's a mod game. It's called Enderal, and it's made for Skyrim, but it's a complete separate game that uses Skyrim to play on. And so I'm putting some of those games over there. I've got games. There's some games that I'm recording right now that I haven't started over there yet, like Amnesia, A Machine for Pigs. I'm recording that. That's going to go over there. Resident Evil. I'm waiting next month, I think it is, or no, 2 months from now, the new Andromeda Mass Effect's going to come out, and I'm going to start playing that. And I play Elite Dangerous over there. Bill's wasted. There you go, Craig. Got to put carrots on this thing, huh? Let me get that combine emptied here. Let's see, Troy's doing this one. Let me get this guy over there. I have Just Cause 2, Mike, but I haven't recorded it. Those kind of games I'm not real good at. I have real poor eye-to-hand coordination. I'm not very good at shooting games. Renner, you guys created a monster. Hey Jim, how you doing? Good to have you in the stream. We're just having a little fun over here. Daryl Walker's in the house. Hey Daryl, good to have you here. Daryl. Hey, Daryl. You seem to spend a lot of time in the airports, buddy. Daryl lives in the Philippines and works in Australia. Is that right, Daryl? I think I got that right. So he flies a lot. He gets a lot of air miles in. All right, this is the last row here. But I don't think I'm going to make it. 92% already. And that's okay. We got soybeans on the other field, so I'm not going to get any windrow off of that. But let me get this finished up here. 72 flights a year. You know what? 72 flights. There's only 52 months or weeks in a year. That's a lot of flying. So you must get to know they don't call them stewardesses anymore, do they? They call them flight attendants. You must get to know them pretty well, because I would imagine that a lot of those flight attendants have the same flights. I think they have routes, don't they, normally? I used to know a gal, but back when I knew this gal, they used to call them stewardesses. Now they call them flight assistants. Yeah, I guess this thing could go a little faster if I turned it off. All right, let's put somebody to work. Who we have here? We have Raymond. Raymond LeDuc is running this combine. All right, let's take this wheat to the farm, so we can pick up the soybeans. Now see, look how slow. I've got this thing floored. See how slow it is getting started? But once you get it started, it really goes pretty good, actually. So Bill, what's up tonight? Anything big? Besides, you said you were wasted. What are you drinking, beer? Bill. Bill. Just make sure you don't take too many of those pills. All right, let's see what we got. Whoa, I overshot that one. All right, so where's the wheat?
Where's the beef?
Now, wait a minute. Oh, there it is. Why on the bottom? I would think wheat would be on the top. Oh, wait a minute. Maybe they have it. No, they don't. No, I was going to say maybe they've got an alphabetical order, but maybe they do. See, barley, canola, compost, grass, hay, maize, oat. No, I don't know how he did it. Just kind of weird. All right, so there's that. We've got 68,000 in wheat. God, we got a half a million in straw already. All right, tell you what, let me grab some more straw. What? Ryan? Welcome back, Ryan. Bill's here. Oh, wait a minute. I didn't check to see if this... I wonder if this silo keeps compost. Does it keep poo? Compost, but no poo. Okay, that's good. It doesn't keep poo, so I'm glad, because I put that other machine in over there, or that other storage unit. All right, what am I looking for? I'm looking for straw. There it is. All right, let's do it. Going left to right. All right, well, I'm just going to get one of these things, I think, because I don't want to back the other one up that ramp. I'm lazy. Great demand at the bakery for sunflowers, which I don't have very many of. Weary? Didn't see you come in, Weary. Glad you're here. More the merrier. All right, I'm going to drop that trailer there. We're going to take this guy and get rid of some straw. I was going to buy that other composter, but oh man, that's going to leave me with absolutely no money. Pickled beet juice? Oh no, pickled beer juice. Did you mean beets? You meant beets, didn't you, Jim? All right, so here we are. I'm going to dump this, and I think I am going to buy that other composter because I do make a lot of money on the compost, and I've got, like I said, I've already got 500,000 units of straw. You don't make as much as you think, though, because that diesel's really expensive. And this thing runs on diesel. But while that's doing that, let me see. I'm thinking that I can, well, maybe right here. Let me see if that's going to work. Manure. There it is. Okay, it's 250,000. I don't have enough. But I've got some compost over here to sell. So let me grab this here. And we'll drive over under there and get that compost. So it's beets for the win. Now I should have brought the trailer like I shouldn't have dropped that trailer. How much is here? Yeah, I shouldn't have dropped the trailer. Darn it. That's right, Craig. The English have a problem with English. We used to eat pickles pig feet all the time. We ate a lot. Like I said, back in the day when you butchered something, you ate everything. I had a lot of head cheese and heart, liver, everything. You ate everything. We even ate the intestines. We had tripe, head cheese. Nothing went to waste. Yeah, Daryl, there's supposedly one on the map. There's one right here in the biogas plant. I could put a placeable one too, but we have one right here. Let's see. Where is it? Is it on this side? There's a place here that makes it, I know. Can't remember where it's at. It's one of these, I think. Can't remember. Anyway, there's a place to make it. What is this one? Let's see what this is. Liquid manure straw, and it makes what? Okay, resources: liquid manure and straw products. Manure. Okay, so you can make manure here, and then but there is a place over here. Where in the heck is it? Hi, David. How you doing? Yeah, that's. I know there is, and I'm trying to find it. Where is it? Is that what's over here? Is that what this is? You can make fertilizer here, but I know there's a place where you can make liquid fertilizer. Always required. Oh, darn it. I know there's a place here that you can make it. All right, I'm lost. But I know there is. Ryan, get some bacon. It's up front, Brian? Okay. It's up front. Is that this one here? No, that's not it. No, that's not it. Up front. Up front. Up front. I know it's here. I saw it on my tour. I'm just blind right now for some reason. Oh, shoot. All right, how many times have I run by it? Anybody? You gone past it before the silos. Before the silos. Over here, over here, over here, over here. I'm running too fast, I know. Before the silos. Are you calling these silos? What are you looking for? I don't know. I'm just wasting time. Gone past it before the silos. You were at it. Same as the fertilizer on the left-hand side. Okay, so it's the same as the fertilizer on the left-hand side. Okay, I got you. So you can make it here. I knew you could. But I do have a placeable one, too. So now that I've wasted all that time, I'll get back and sell this and put in another composter. I make a lot of money on compost. Watch, I'll show you. This is 50,000 compost. Let's see what I make. The orange machine. Okay, thanks, Craig. Yeah, I know. I ran by it 5 times. I run really fast. $60,000, that's not bad for just using straw to make compost. $60,000, but that's going to give me enough. I'd have more except for, you know, when you sell stuff, the price goes down. And I just sold some compost earlier, so there you go. Darn economy, what's that all about? But I've got enough now that I can buy the other composter, and I can't double it because this one holds $100,000. And this one's only going to hold 50. So let me jump out of here and put one in just because we can. That one right there. Ooh, let me spin around here. Man, this thing's big. This one might be bigger than that one over there. I don't know. Okay, so I don't want to get too close to that building because you can make compost for sale over there, and if I get too close to here, I can't use those things right there. So I think maybe right about there. And I can always move it. If I move it, I wish I could not set it up on this thing. I hate it because you have that curb to go over. But let's go get some more straw. With grass too, Jim. Yeah, that's good to know. I have I don't have very much grass right now. I got lots of straw. We were talking about that earlier. Why do you have to feed the sheep grass when they're eating in a field of grass all day? And I kind of figured that maybe that the grass is always greener on the other side of the fence, and so you're just trying to keep the sheep happy by feeding them grass that you cut from the other side of the fence. If that makes sense, I don't know. Hey, Nate. Nate McDowell's in the house. All right, let's grab some straw here. All right, Wiry, that's good to know. The one in, let's see, is it the one on Suithammer? I don't know if I ever got any more than 100,000 in it. I wish the silage maker held a little bit more. Go fill this puppy up. I need to get a tractor down there too because I've got some fuel down there, but I don't have a tractor. I've only got one tractor. No, I have two. I've got that big Challenger. I got that noisy John Deere. I need to do something with that. I like it, and I like the sound it makes, but it's just really loud. Kind of like me. Yeah, see this truck here, it gets going pretty good, 50 miles an hour. It just is slow getting there. But I kind of decided I like that. Kind of like Pigpen. I bought Pigpen and I thought, oh man, Pigpen's messed up. But the more I used it, the more I liked it. Make myself dizzy again. Man, this thing backs up slow, doesn't it? All right, let me go get another trouble. Where's my tractor? He's being used. Oh, I could have taken this right directly there, couldn't I have? That's funny, Jim. Mexican gold, Colombian gold, Mexican red. Fermenter 5000 holds 500K and makes digest. What's Fermenter 5000? Is that on this farm? Oh, I use the other trailer when I pick up fruit. I just don't use it to haul the hay because it doesn't back up very well. I mean, it does, but it's kind of a pain. That's why I got a dump truck, because it's easy to back up. Yeah, that's the one, Wyrie. That's the one I wish held more. I wish it held more. I modded the one that I used to hold, I think, 1 million. Can't remember now. Might have been more. All right, let's see what we can get in this thing. I keep forgetting I've got that auto-save mod in here, and it pauses the game every once in a while. Makes it look like the game's having a hiccup. Makes it look like the game just ate a Costco hot dog and it's burping the alphabet. Okay, let's get down here where we can see that. All right, we're up over 100,000. 130, 140, 150, 170, 180. 200,000, and we still got a little bit of straw left. All right, I gotta drop this like it's hot. Go over and grab that fuel tank. I don't know how much fuel I left in this tank, but fuel's expensive. I'm gonna have to make some. Well, there's enough to get it started. It takes a lot of fuel. All right, there, that's going there. Let's grab... Let's grab some more compost. I can make some money here. Grab Mr. Compost Man. I had a couple people suggest different names for Mr. Compost Man. I couldn't think of anything when I made it, so I just called it Mr. Compost Man. That's kind of boring. I think Bob left. He had to go to bed. It's 2:30 where he's at. He had a name, and I don't remember what it was, but it was pretty funny. Whoa, got a pretty good sized load there. 86% on this. What? Xbox gang, how you doing? Is it Xbox One? I have the game on Xbox One, but I play it on the PC. Hey Brennan, how are you? Thank you very, very much. I appreciate it. Anyway, I do play it on the Xbox One, but I record it on the PC. Excuse me. But anyway, yeah, I've got it on the Xbox One too. I play it when I want to just relax in the living room and play a game. I'll play it on the Xbox One. Hey Waylon, how are you? Glad to see you in the stream. So yeah, I'm using the PC right now. I'm a PC player. I've got all consoles, but I don't play them much. I've got a PlayStation, the new one, whatever they call it. PlayStation Pro. I've got an Xbox One S. I got an Xbox 360. I've got an Xbox. I got a PlayStation 1, 2, 3, and Pro. All the Nintendos. I've even got a Wii or two laying around here somewhere. But I'm not much of a console player. The only time I play consoles is when I go on vacation because I don't want to haul my computer around. So I'll haul my Xbox and my PlayStation and I'll catch up on all the games that I didn't get to play throughout the rest of the year. But then I go on vacation a lot, so. My gamer tag's the same. My gamer name is the same everywhere. Just RudeMan53. Like I said earlier, can you believe it? There's 52 other people ruder than me. All right, now somebody pointed out earlier, I think Dar did, I can use a trailer over here right there, but this one over here, I'm going to have to pick up using this machine. So I think I'm just going to park this machine over here because I don't need it at the other composter. I'll just park this right here. That way I don't have to use one of those awful conveyor belts. I hate those things. Conveyor belts in this game are so bad. I have Far Cry. I've never played it. I have all the Far Cries. I've got about 200 or 300 games in Steam. I would say probably 90% I've never even loaded on my computer. I just buy them when they're on sale. And one of these days I'll play them. But I've got all the Far Cries. I just don't play them. I've got all the Hitman. I got just tons of games. I just don't have the time to play them all. Where'd I leave my trailer? Oh, there it is. Never mind. I gotta go check on the cedar. Oh, when was I doing that? All right, let me grab the trailer. I'm falling down on the job. Do I do logging? I hate logging. I hate it. I hate it. That's the only thing I got upset about this game for was I bought this game for a farming game. I don't know many farmers that are also loggers. I mean, I know that farmers may go down and cut a tree down if it's in the way so that they can plow. But no, I don't do the logging. I'm not good at it. I don't have good eye-hand coordination and it's just terrible. It's, you know, trying to get the stupid logs to stay on the trailer and picking them up and all that kind of junk just doesn't interest me at all. So that being said, I kind of like some of the stuff Stevie did on this one for the logging, and I may start logging, you never know. I was thinking about that the other day. I said, you know, Stevie did put a lot of stuff on here for logging. And I thought, well, crud. Maybe I'll start logging. But I tell you, if I do start logging, I'm going to use that mod they made. There's a mod that they've got out there that you can kind of mow the trees down and it makes chips out of it. That's what I probably would use. Bye, Mike. Thanks for coming in. Appreciate it. Or is it Mike that's leaving? Packers? Two teams, I think. Oh, yeah, you're probably right, Craig. It probably is two teams. I'll tell you what, Craig, talking about that, if my family was pro-abortion, I wouldn't have my granddaughter down right now. And I can't imagine not having my granddaughter. She's just everything in my life right now. Hey, Key. Key Austin. Is that how you pronounce that? Key? Key Y-E? You going to bed, Bill? Because I'm about done. I'm going to put a couple more minutes in, and I got my 2 hours in, and go out and have some dinner with my wife. I haven't eaten dinner yet. Wait for this guy to stop. I could probably drive up next to him. I've got these things set. Oh, there he goes. Got these things set to unload pretty quickly. Yeah, see, I got that thing set to unload pretty fast. Patriots and Falcons for the Super Bowl. Just looked. All right, Patriots and Falcons. I don't even know when the Super Bowl is. I've actually only watched one in my life. Normally what I do is I'll come in at halftime and watch the commercials. And then I'll come in the last 10 minutes just to see the end. Because the end is the only thing that matters anyway. It died again, huh? Well, it's 6 o'clock. And I said I was going to stream from 4 to 6. I told my wife. You guys know. I always have to make a deal with my wife. So she lets me stream when I want to, but I have to have dinner with her and spend time with her. That's just the way it is. So I hope you had fun. I hope the politics didn't scare you off. I hate talking politics. But at any rate, I hope you had fun. If you did, then come see me again. Watch some of my videos, and I'll see you either on a live stream or on the videos in the next episode. In the meantime, happy farming. I appreciate every one of you coming out. Thank you very much, and I'll see you next time. Good night.